cookies.
Yeah, me too.
Maybe Marianne knew when I was coming home and she...
I made the cookies. I don't know how they're going to taste, but... Oh, God. Oh, I missed you so much. I have so missed you.
Well, hypnosis...
So, did you beat Vicky at bank robber?
Yeah, Jessica too.
Oh, so I guess things were okay for you over there, huh?
Yeah, but, you know, wasn't home.
No, I'm sorry about that. Just with everything going on here, your father and I thought it would be better if you stayed in Aunt Vicky's for a couple of days.
Yeah, I know.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot that you and your mom need to talk about, so I'm going to go back to the office. Why don't you call me later if you want to talk?
Do you guys hate each other?
Stafer's ready.
Oh, I don't hate your mom, son. Why would you even think something like that?
I'm not stupid, Dad. Part of the reason why you haven't stayed at Aunt Vicky's is because you and mom got into a big fight about what happened with Mr. Coulson.
Well, yeah, but a lot of people were shaken up by that.
Yeah, I know. And Aunt Vicky and Natalie, everyone got real quiet around me. No one wanted me to watch news on TV about Mr. Coulson killing Jen. I did see the news a couple of times, though. I saw you and Mom.
Oh, sweetie.
I saw how you looked at Dad when he was going to arrest Mr. Coulson in front of everybody.
It was just a really confusing time.
You didn't just look confused. You looked...
I was upset. It just was really very upsetting.
But that doesn't mean we hate each other.
But why is what Mr. Coulson did making you guys fight even more?
Yeah, but we're not going to do that anymore.
No. We're just going to... We're going to concentrate on you.
Just because you say it's going to be better doesn't make it better.
Matthew.
I'm going to go upstairs for a while.
What you did, it didn't just ruin my life. It's killing your son, the son you claim to care so much about. I will do my best to hide how I feel about you in front of him. I'll do my best.
Well?
Hey. How you doing?
Okay. I miss my room. You know, my computer, music and stuff.
I hope you understand why you weren't here. Why you had to go to Aunt Vicky's. It just was a crazy time and everything was upside down and the press was outside the door and I just... And... feel very well, and I didn't feel like I could take care of you. I could barely take care of myself.
Maybe I could have helped, Mom. I'm not a baby anymore.
I know. And you know what? I'll have to remember that next time.
I know you feel bad because Mr. Coulson fooled you. But I feel bad, too. I could have stopped the wedding, and I didn't. I'm really sorry. It's all my fault. Everything that happened.
No, it's not. Matthew, it's not your fault.
Dad's always talking about how he follows his gut. If I just would have followed mine, maybe Jen would still be alive.
Oh, no, sweetie. No. Shh. No. Oh, this isn't your fault. Please, sweetheart, this is not your fault, okay?
I think we got all of it, Mom.
Yep, I think we've got the last shred of Daniel Coulson out of this house.
Goodbye, Mr. Coulson.
Goodbye, Mr. Coulson. I'm sorry, sweetie. I'm really sorry I brought him into this house.
You know what, Mom? When I make a bonehead play in soccer, my coach just tells me to shake it off and just keep on going. That's what you need to do.
Okay. Thanks, Coach. Thanks very much. I will, I'll take your advice. But if you don't mind, can I just sit on the bench a little longer?
Sure.
I'm afraid that might be somebody who wants me to get back in the game.
You want me to tell them you're not ready?
I don't think I'm setting a very good example for you. You might get the feeling that I'm like
a chicken.
Yeah, that's the word I was looking for.
I'll take care of this.
Hi, Matthew.
My mom doesn't want to see anyone.
Tell her I need her help.
I'm not sure.
Help?
I'm in desperate need of a best friend fix.
I'm in desperate need of being needed. Come on, Ann. Thanks, Coach, but I think I had to get off the bench for this one.
I'm glad you're talking to someone. If you need me, I'll be next door. I think Ricky has a new foosball table.
You got an hour, and then you have to come home to bed.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Quite a support system here.
Yeah, I feel bad about what I put him through with his stupid marriage and everything.
Nora, I'm so sorry.
I really don't want to talk about it eventually, and I really, really don't. So, what's going on?
A lot. And I don't want to dump on you since you're in the middle of your own crisis. But if you're up to it, I could use a friendly shoulder.
Is this like a diversionary tactic?
Partially. My life's falling apart.
John, what happened?
I broke it off. I love him. I love him so much, but I had to walk away. It's over.
Hey, Dick.
Yes, sir.
Daniel Coulson is being transferred today, and so far the media hasn't caught wind of it, so I'd like to keep it that way. All right? I don't want it to turn into another circus.
Okay. It'll be good to clear out the garbage, sir.
He's not soon enough for me. Surprised to see you back.
I work here.
Well, I know, but I thought that you'd want to take just a little bit more time off.
My new job couldn't wait.
What new job?
I've been appointed to replace Daniel. I'm the new district attorney. So I guess that makes me more or less someone that you report to.
I still don't... Last time I checked, I don't work for the district attorney. I didn't realize that they'd offer you the job.
I ran against Daniel.
I know. I was in your camp.
But now you think my appointment was a mistake because of my relationship with Daniel?
I didn't say that.
I may have lousy taste in men, but I'm a damn fine prosecutor.
I know that, but I just think that you could take a little more time.
I'm fine.
Well, yeah, but it's okay if you're not. It's okay if you're... Still angry at me for the way Coulson's arrest went down, but I don't think that's going to make for a good working relationship now that you're the DA.
Now that I'm the DA, we should actually set some ground rules.
Ground rules?
Yes. My personal life is not going to interfere with my work, and my personal feelings about you will not interfere with my working with you.
Okay, I'm just worried you're rushing back too soon.
Tell me, Beau, if I was anyone else... The new kid on the block, the new DA. Would you be this interested?
No. But you're not anyone else. You're Matthew's mom.
Yes. And we're doing fine there. Let's do fine here, too.
Fine? How could you be doing fine?
Because that's what I am. That's what I have to be.
Who's trying to buy...
My daughter will never see another sunrise. She will never have another dream, another hope. She will never fall in love or have a family. You stole her life away from her. Beau, I want you to promise me that he is going to pay for what he did to my baby.
The only thing that I can promise you is to hand over enough evidence to the DA to make sure that he's put away forever.
Beau, may I have a word with the accused?
Decker?
can't prosecute you. For obvious reasons. I can't testify against you. But I don't want to go through that hell. That humiliation. I don't want to sit there in a court of law. Tell everyone that the man I married has lied to me with every word, breath, and touch. So I'm not going to. The way I see it, you owe me. And you're going to pay me back. And this is how. You'll stop the lying. You will confess. You will admit what you have done. And you'll do it for Riley. And you'll do it for Jen, so that she can rest in peace. And at the very least, you will say it to me. Here. Now. So that I can have a little peace of mind.
What do you want me to say?
The words. I'm guilty. Even if you don't say it in court, I need you to say it to me. Right here, right now. I'm not wearing a wire. I'm not recording it. I just need you to say it to me. Right now.
What do you want to hear, Laura? The truth? That I've done unspeakable things? That I murdered an innocent young girl? Lied to you? To Mark? Destroyed my son's life along with my own? I'm guilty.
Is everything okay?
He's all yours.
Close.
John's out in the field.
I wasn't looking for him. I'm not even thinking about him.
Did John check on those names from my yearbook?
Yeah, we're running them through the computer right now.
I really don't think any of my friends could be the killer, Commissioner.
Well, maybe it's somebody that, that you knew, but not in the way that you thought you did.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I'll talk to you later.
Yeah. You just heard that. All right, Nora, I've apologized before for the way that you found out about Coulson, but I'll do it again. I'm truly sorry.
What if the shoe were on the other foot? What if the roles were reversed and I knew something about someone that you cared about?
I hate secrets, so if... I'd want to know the truth about someone I cared for, no matter what it is.
Okay. Bo, I think there's something you should know.
Okay, Nora, what have you got?